So people can speedrun basically anything these days, so what about life? And I don't mean any percent where you can use questionable methods to reach an end screen, I'm talking about 100% completion, where you live a long and fulfilling life. The first thing that comes to mind is eating really poorly and getting very little exercise and stuff like that, because getting a heart attack is one way to speedrun quickly. The problem is that it's sort of a gray area between any percent and 100% because eating fatty food can be seen as fulfilling, but you obviously miss out on quite a bit of life. So we'll need some alternative method to save time. Luckily for us, physics has a very simple solution. When people speedrun, there are two clocks that they can opt to use. In-game time, which is a timer built into the game, or real time, which would be the time measured outside of the game on real-world clocks. In the context of speedrunning life, in-game time would be the time the player measures, while real time would be the time measured on Earth. Normally these quantities are the same, but thanks to special relativity, we can influence the speed at which these clocks would run. You might have heard of something called the twin paradox, or the thought experiment in which we have a set of twins. Twin A gets blasted off at near light speed, while twin B stays on Earth. When twin A returns, they would have aged less than twin B. Of course, this isn't actually a paradox because we have the math and physics that can perfectly predict and calculate the exact age difference, but it's paradoxical in the sense that it doesn't make sense. Anyways, we can use this concept to help us in our speedrun. Obviously, we can't put ourselves on the rocket because any speedrun attempt we make appears longer on Earth and results in a slower time. So instead, we'll need to metabolize the solar system, or basically just the sun, and use the materials to construct an earthly rocket ship. Assuming we keep a negligible amount of mass to survive and use the rest as fuel for a nuclear fusion-powered engine, we can speedrun the rest of our life in about 8.43 Earth years. Of course, we'd need to limit the acceleration of our rocket to 1G to avoid any long-term health issues. But building rocket ships is hard, and you'd probably have to wait a fairly long time before technology catches up to the point where such a rocket ship would even become a feasible engineering project. So we'll need to consider a different method for speedrunning life. So the alternative method that I've come up with involves some very specific and incredibly detailed physics. You're going to have to ask your mom to sew you a new sweater or something. Since, it's a really bad yo mama so fat joke here, and since sewing requires you to focus on the point of the needle to get an accurate thread, we can say that your mom's sewing is equivalent to an incredibly large mass concentrated on a single point, which are the necessary conditions for the formation of black holes. So before your mom begins sewing, you're going to need a rocket ship that will take you far from the Earth. So you'll need to somehow sneak onto the Artemis II with enough supplies to last the rest of your life. The moon will likely still orbit the newly formed black hole, while the Earth would be dangerously close or even fall into the event horizon. And it just so happens that gravity also creates time dilation. Now the exact numbers vary heavily on the size of the black hole formed and the proximity to the black hole, but since the moon would be much further away than the Earth, time would pass much more slowly than it would on the moon, meaning you could potentially speed run your life in what seems like a few hours on Earth. Okay, but bad jokes aside, there isn't any good way to get a significant time save on your speedrun using physics. The only realistic way is to, ironically, slow down. Take a moment to live your life to the fullest and settle down, because the faster you move through life, the higher your speed relative to an observer on the surface of Earth will be, which will ultimately lose time on your speedrun. So it turns out gaming 24/7 is already the optimal route to speedrunning one's life. And no, becoming an astronaut is not a realistic speedrun route.